Hi, my name is Cody Redding, and I'd like to introduce Categorical Depth Distribution Network for Monocular 3D Object Detection, or CADET for short. This work has been developed at the Trail Lab at the University of Toronto, in collaboration with Ali Harake, Julia Che, and Stephen Waslender. CADET is a deep neural network that performs monocular 3D object detection by estimating 3D bounding boxes of objects using only a single camera. The key feature of our method is the prediction of a categorical depth distribution for each image pixel in order to accurately locate image information in 3D space. We transform our 3D representation into the bird's eye view perspective to perform 3D object detection. To start, I'd like to ask a simple question. What makes monocular 3D detection so hard? Well, monocular cameras do not capture depth, since depth is lost when 3D scene information is projected back onto the image plane. Without depth, locating objects in 3D space, especially the depths of objects, is very challenging. To combat this, many methods learn the lost depth with a neural network in order to project the image pixels back into 3D space. So, how should we perform this projection? Well, we can answer this with a Goldilocks-style approach. Let's start with the too big approach. Here, methods project each pixel to all possible depths. The issue with this is somewhat obvious. Image information is repeated along the projection way, which increases the difficulty in locating objects in the 3D representation. The opposite is the too small approach. Here, a single depth value is estimated for each pixel and projected to a single location in 3D space. This approach suffers where depth estimation is poor, as image pixels will often be projected to incorrect locations without a consideration of depth estimation uncertainty. Just like Goldilocks, our work takes a just-right approach. We project pixels to all possible depths, but weigh the projection by the estimated depth probabilities. Doing so allows our network to place image information at the correct locations while encoding depth estimation uncertainty. The architecture of CADET is as follows. Taking an image as input, we predict both image features F and depth distributions D using convolutional networks. Each feature pixel is multiplied with its associated depth bin probabilities via an outer product, projecting our image representation into our 3D frustum grid G. The frustum features G are then transformed into a voxel representation V. Sampling points in each voxel are projected into the frustum grid using the camera calibration matrix. The frustum features are then sampled using the sampling points in order to populate each voxel feature. Next, the voxel grid is collapsed to a bird's eye view grid. The height axis of the voxel grid V is concatenated along the channel axis, followed by a channel reduction layer to retrieve the original number of channels. This forms bird's eye view feature grid B. Finally, 3D object detection is then performed using a bird's eye view detection network in order to get the final output voxels. CADET achieves state-of-the-art performance on both the Kitty and Waymo datasets. From the input image, we can visualize our depth estimation results, where brighter colors indicate closer depths. We also visualize our bird's eye view features, in which objects can be distinctly located. Finally, we overlay detections on the LiDAR point cloud in order to show the accuracy of our method. We can see here that most objects are accurately detected with only a single camera. We also compare the Goldilocks approaches for image projection into 3D. We validate that our just right approach achieves the highest performance, as it places image information in the correct locations while encoding depth estimation uncertainty. Finally, we visualize the depth distributions, where brighter colors indicate higher probabilities. We also visualize the average depth distributions at each depth bin. We can see that the distributions become wider as a function of depth, and the depth probabilities also reduce as well. This is expected behavior, as it reflects the increased difficulty of depth estimation at longer ranges. If you are interested in our work, more details can be found in our project page. We also provide a code release for our work CADET as well. Thank you.